hear a word that would inspire us. We've come to hear a word, oh God, that will help us to pick ourselves up and continue on the journey. I, your servant, stand before you empty. Fill me so that the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart will be acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. And I ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
I realize that this is February 28th, and the month of February leaves today. And this is the month that...
Tomorrow.
Well, whenever it leaves, it's almost over. And we have not... We have not given our Black History message, but since we all Black, we got a history. But the Lord would have me tell somebody that it's going to be okay.
All right.
I've had the opportunity to speak with some folk this past week who have been in some difficult positions. I've had the opportunity to hear about situations that are almost hopeless. And I'm concerned that there are some people whom the Lord has blessed, brought them out of some dire situations, and they have not returned to give God no glory. I'm concerned.
Yes, that is sad.
That there have been people who crawled to me begging for anything and everything. And when God opened the windows of heaven, when God put food on the table, clothes on their back, all they're concerned about is what makes them happy. I'm mad. I'm not angry. I'm mad that the devil uses us in such a way that when we want something, we cry out to the Lord. As soon as he blesses us, we turn our backs on him. If I were God, I'd slap you in your mouth if you did that to me. But God is so good. He's merciful. I'll jack you up. That's why we have a God. He knows my kind ain't got it together all the time.
All right, preach.
I'm only saying that. I'm not a violent person. But I just like when folk misuse God's goodness. It makes me mad. So many people are so sincere. They're crying out to the Lord just for another chance. And there are others who just playing with them. As soon as you get arrested, they dance off. And then when bad times, they come back.
Yes.
And God still blesses them.
Yes.
I didn't mean to go off on. I didn't mean to go off on, because it's none of you. It's none of you. None of you. But I know what happens when we allow ourselves to be used by the devil. But I also know when we allow God to use us, what happens.
Amen.
So we're going to concentrate on what God does in our lives. The author of the text is Matthew, the tax collector. He was one of the 12. The chapter begins with Christ departing from Jericho, and a great multitude follows him. They were following Christ for various reasons. For some, it was the loaves. For some, it was the love. While for others, they were looking for Christ to reign. In this massive crowd, there were two persons not following the master. In fact, they were sitting by the wayside. The Bible says these two men had something in common. They were both blind. Now, I believe they were sitting close to each other having a conversation. My sanctified imagination says perhaps they were talking about some current event. Perhaps as they were talking, they received a news flash. They heard that Jesus had passed by. They had no time to ask who was with Jesus. They had no time to find out if he was even in a hurry. They had no time to ask what he was wearing or how he looked. In a moment's time, I believe they realized that it was Jesus who turned water into wine. It was he who made the dumb to speak and the deaf to hear. They must have realized it was that Jesus who gave life to the dead and sight to the blind. They realized that the shape that they were in, they needed a breakthrough. And so they brought verse 30 to life and uttered, "Have mercy on us, O Lord." I believe when we find ourselves in situations when we hear that Jesus is passing by, you need to understand that just because Jesus is passing by, he does not know your situation. Don't for a minute believe that Christ didn't know about these two blind men. He knows everything. He could have easily made his way to them. But there comes a time when God wants us to go to him, not him come to us. If you want something from him, you ought to seek him. If God is good enough to bless you, you can at least go to him. And so they said, have mercy. Now, what this tells me is that Christ knows everything. God knows everything. They didn't have to tell him to have mercy, but they did. So if the two blind men had to tell God to have mercy on them, what makes us think that we don't have to tell God about our situation? We don't have to belabor the point. We don't have to give a long dissertation. But the Lord wants us to talk to him. He wants us to talk to him continuously. He wants us to talk to him all the time. It's amazing how much time we can spend in conversation about trivial matters, but have difficulty talking about the things of the Lord. Everything that we talk about on earth is going to cease to be. But everything you talk to God about in the spiritual will last forever. But don't you realize we spend more time talking about earthly stuff that's going to cease one day than we do about spiritual things that will live forever? We spend time with the AT&T, Verizon, Sprint, all them folk will go out of business if all folk talked about the spiritual things.
Well,
y'all know them, right? I know them, right? But God has said you don't need a 2-year contract
all right
with a carrier or a 4-year contract, or whatever. All you have to do is desire to speak, and he will listen. So the two men, they call out, "Have mercy." And behold, two men sitting by the wayside. They were not afraid to cry out to Jesus for mercy. I want someone here today to know that there is healing in the name of Jesus.
Oh, yes.
I want you to know that when you cry out for help, expecting to receive your breakthrough, folk around you may not like it, and they will not, and they will probably tell you to be quiet, but don't hold your peace. Don't let anybody stop you from crying out. Don't let anybody stop you from getting your breakthrough. Don't let anybody tell you it don't take all that.
Yes.
For some of us, it takes all that, handful.
Yes.
If we can give so much time to worldly stuff, we should be able to give a little time to the Lord. If we just spend some time celebrating a touchdown or a 3-point shot from mid-court, we ought to be every now and then to lift up our hands and say, "Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your name. Hallelujah."
Thank you.
Thank
you.
In fact,
Lord, thank you.
It wouldn't be such a bad idea that whenever you thought about thanking God,
Hallelujah.
You would just thank him.
Thank you.
You could be on scepter.
Yes.
People do some stupid stuff on Saturday. You might as well say, "Glory, hallelujah." Just think for a minute.
Yes, sir.
If you got on a bus and start saying, "Glory, hallelujah," people would look at you. They might think you were crazy, but I believe God would work a miracle in the lives of someone who needed a miracle. All he wants you to do is be bold enough to give him some glory.
Preaching.
Matthew 8 says, when he came down from the mountain, great multitudes followed him. And behold, there came a leper and worshiped him, saying, "Lord, will thou make me clean?" Jesus put forth his hand and cleansed the leper. If he cleansed the leper, why won't he take care of your condition? Since God is not a respecter of person, if you ask him, he will grant it unto you. Matthew 8:5 says, Jesus healed the centurion's servant. Matthew 8:40 says, when Jesus came into Peter's house, he saw his wife's mother laid and sick of the fever. And he touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she arose and ministered unto them. If you just allow the Lord to touch you, he can heal you. If you just allow the Lord to speak over your life, he can change your situation. I don't know about you, but I'm not going to take a chance on missing out on my healing or my blessing by being silent. I'm going to cry out to the Lord and ask him for what I want.
Yes, yes.
Not only have you heard about the few people we just talked about, but I believe that there's some folk in the house of the Lord who can say that the Lord has heard their cry.
Well, hallelujah.
I believe there's somebody sitting in the sanctuary.
Thank you.
That the Lord has touched from the top of their head to the sole of their feet. I just believe there was somebody who was in the hospital and they didn't know whether or not you were going to make it out. But God touched them, delivered them, healed them. got them home. Put
yes, sir.
In their hands.
Yes, sir.
Stop it in their
Hallelujah.
Feet. Put a song in their heart and gave them a desire to go hard to see what they is.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Well,
I believe someone knows what it feels like to be driving down a highway, and all of a sudden, the Lord just moves you out of the way where they could have been a disaster. I believe there's somebody knows how it feels when the strong winds blow. You wake up and your house is still intact.
Yes.
I just believe.
Yes, sir.
We know how good. How good God
has been.
Yes.
How good God is.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Verse 31 says, and the multitude rebuked them because they should have held their peace.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
But they cried the more,
yes,
saying, have mercy on us.
Yes.
Lord, thou son of David. That lets me know sometimes you're going to have to cry out more than once. Sometimes you're going to have to be verbal in your crying out. I know if the pain gets harsh enough, you're going to call on the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I believe when the situation gets tight enough,
mm-hmm,
you're going to have the Lord coming to your situation.
Yes.
But I submit to you, don't wait until it gets too tight.
Yes.
Call on Him.
Oh.
Call on Him.
Oh.
As soon as you have a desire in me, call on Him.
Oh. Thank you.
And He'll come
yes,
to your rescue. Verse 32 says, and Jesus stood still and called them and said, what will ye that I should do unto you? Verse 33, they say unto him, Lord, that our eyes may be opened. Whatever it is, God will do it if you believe. If you have a desire for God to work in your life, ask Him.
Yes.
And then, may I suggest to you that once God has blessed you, once God has healed you, once He has set you free and done what you've asked, won't you just give Him some praise?
Mm-hmm.
Won't you just give Him the honor?
Yes.
And please tell somebody,
mm-hmm,
about the goodness of the Lord. There's someone in your circle that needs a touch from Jesus. There's somebody on your job needs to know that God says high, looks low. There's someone in your neighborhood who's on the brink of disaster. But if you tell them about the God that you serve, you can prevent them from going down for the third time.
Mm-hmm.
And I know all of us are astute. Y'all bright. Y'all brilliant. But you didn't always know the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
You didn't always have a desire. I know you've been in church a long time.
Hallelujah.
But you didn't always have a desire to serve Him.
Mm-hmm.
But ain't you glad? Ain't
Amen.
You glad? I mean, it's not grammatical, but ain't you glad that you served Him? Ain't you glad you called on Him? Aren't you glad you know Him for yourself? Isn't it good to know that whatever comes, you can call on the name of the Lord? Wherever you go, you can call on the name of the Lord.
Jesus.
And
Jesus.
When you call Him, He'll answer.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
When you call Him, He'll be there. He has the power. God has proven himself.
Oh, yes.
If you're near death, he raised Lazarus from the dead.
Yes.
If he gave sight to the blind, he can help you out of your little situation.
Oh, yes.
If he turned water into wine, he can give you water that when you drink of it, you'll never thirst again. If he fed 5,000 men, not including women and children, with 5 barley loaves and 2 little fish, he can open up shop right at me. Shopping bag and feed you. Your cover may be bare now, but if you call on the name of the Lord,
say so,
he will fill it, to overflow. If you believe that God can do it, he'll do it. Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy
on us.
Yes, yes.
Verse 4 of 34 says, so Jesus had compassion on them and touched their eyes, and immediately their eyes received sight, and they followed him. It's important to know that once God has blessed you, once God has come into your situation, once he has made that honorary husband or that vindictive wife come into compliance with his love, once your wayward children realize that they need to honor the mother and father, once your boss on the job realize that he don't boss all your life, from 9 to 5 he got it, but after that you're on your own. Once they realize these things, and you can deal with a 9 to 5, because there's a God who sits high and looks low. There's a God who's on your side.
All right.
When you come home, open the door.
Yes, sir.
He will greet you with rest. He will greet you with peace. He will greet you with tranquility. He will greet you with whatever you need. You don't need a husband, you got Jesus. You don't need a wife, you got Jesus. If you got Jesus, you got a God. He will greet you, welcome you into your home, and says, I thank you for being faithful. Because you were faithful, I'm going to be faithful. When you say, Lord, have mercy, he has mercy upon you, and he grants you his everlasting wishes. So whatever you're dealing with,
yes, yes,
I know to you it's traumatic. I know to you it may seem like all hope is lost. It may appear that all the positive steps you have taken are now being negated by one bad situation. Don't let one bad situation stop you from believing. Because first of all, there are going to be more bad situations.
Yes, yes.
But there is more good
than there is
bad. Sometimes we concentrate on the bad. But if you look back over your life, I guarantee you that you've had more good than bad. And I know you're blessed because you're sitting here. You may not have what you want. You may be puzzled about, you may be unsure of the future. You may not even know what's going to happen when you go home. But that's all right. God knows. If God knows, he has already put in place a plan. He has already worked it out. And while he's done all that, you can sing your song. You can dance your dance. You can clap your hands. You can stomp your feet, because it's already been done. Enjoy life. Give God glory.
Yes.
Give God honor. Give God, but lift up your hands and say, thank you, Lord. I've had some tough times, but it's almost over now. I know it's been dark, but it's light at the end of the tunnel. I've had to suffer, but Lord, I didn't suffer by myself. You've always been there with me, and I thank you. I glorify you, and I magnify
Hallelujah.
Your name.
Hallelujah.
And the day will come
yes.
when this old warfare is over.
Yes.
And you struggle for the last time.
Oh, yes.
The Lord will welcome you into his kingdom.
Yes.
Where you can serve him forevermore.
Amen.
So the little battles that we fight here, trust me, it's all worth it. The setbacks that we suffer, it's all worth it. Because God will not let you, just like he did Job. You may get down to your lowest point, but when you get down to your lowest point, that's when God gets the business. He really works miracles. He'll bring you out of the situation. Don't give in. Please don't give up. Please don't quit, and please don't stop. Put your hand in God's hand and let him work it out. Say, Lord, have mercy on us. The doors of the church open. There may be someone that the Lord is